By the 2022 season, we're going to have 90% of our product line made with sustainable materials. My name is Rob Pickles, and I'm the Advanced Development Project Manager here at Pearl Izumi. My job is incredibly varied. I get to do fun projects like science, like we're doing here with some testing. And I also get to develop solutions to problems that the everyday cyclist has in new and meaningful ways. For this project, we are evaluating our fall 2019 Merino wool product to see how it compares to a synthetic garment that's more common in the cycling world. For the past few years, I've been traveling to the ACE Environmental Wind Tunnel in Oshawa, Canada. It's about an hour outside of Toronto. And this is terrific for us because we're able to control the environment that mimics conditions that riders are going to be facing outside, which is incredibly important to ensure that our data is actually valid for people riding their bikes. In this environmental wind tunnel, we're able to control the solar output, the temperature, the humidity, the wind speed, the rider's workload. We can even make it rain if we want. What we're doing today, the purpose of this is we're looking at comparing some product that's coming out in fall 19 to some prototypes. Each of them are in different materials, and we're basically just looking to get your feedback. The wind speed will be 30 kilometers an hour. Temperature will be 8 degrees, humidity will be 60%. And then the solar lights will be set at sort of midwinter sun, so to say. Ryan, I'm going to put this temperature and humidity sensor on here. This is going to be recording throughout the trial so that we can see what's happening in the microclimate between your skin and that jersey combination. So this is going to stay on the entire time. The product that we're making, the plated construction, combines synthetic fibers on one face with wool fibers on another face, and we've strategically placed those for the most maximizing benefit to the rider.
Okay, go ahead and pedal. I'm going to bring you to 180 watts. Mile and a half faster. Good coast. Perfect.
We're just looking for some more wind.
We're about to. I'm going to give it to you right now. You ready? All right, guys, we're ready to start. Can we come up to 30 kph?
Yep, 30 coming up.
We know that wool has these great properties that it insulates when it's wet, and that wool actually, as it gains moisture, will release heat. So we had some hypothesis that wool was going to be comfortable in these cold conditions, but until you see the numbers, you never know exactly what you're going to get. So I had to start one place, and where I started was with the workload that everybody's at. Sort of what's the highest workload that this group of subjects is going to be able to pedal given the length of time that they're out there, right? And so that was 180 watts. And we know that based on the workload, that's how much heat they're going to be generating. The other half of the equation is balancing the environmental conditions. You know, if I pick a place in that 45th parallel, then and a date, I can basically know any time of the year exactly how much sunlight is going to be shining in that area, and the 600 watts per square meter that we're at right here is pretty representative of peak sunlight along that 45th parallel in winter time, and then sort of back calculate from there.
To help achieve our sustainability goals, we've reintroduced wool, a renewable fiber, into our product line. During the design process, we placed the wool on the outside of the base layer and on the inside of the jersey. We designed the pieces this way so that they would work together to transfer moisture from the skin to the outside environment.
Congratulations, guys. You made it through 6 trials for the day. We are done testing. Every one of you did an awesome, awesome job. All right, my man, we're gonna come right down this first column. Don't overthink it. First thing that comes to mind, this is thermal comfort. Anytime we do projects like this, you never know exactly what you're going to get. We know the properties of wool, right? It insulates when it's wet. And so we thought that wool was gonna be very comfortable in these very cool, damp conditions the riders were experiencing. But until you get to see the data, you never know exactly what's going to happen out there.
I think my favorite piece of the day would be this teal undergarment.
Nice. What did you like about it?
I think it really breathed well. It kept you warm, and you wouldn't stay too humid after the exertion.
Yeah, I like this long sleeve. It was very warm, and it breathed well, and
dissipated the moisture, but it's also like pretty fashionable. We all look pretty really, good. Flames. We all look pretty good. Like we got like a boy band thing going on. Like I said.
When analyzing the data, we had extremely positive results that showed the Fall 19 wool product was warmer, it was drier, it had more thermal comfort than the pure synthetic fabrics. And so for us, that was a huge win. It was a great validation of all the hard work that we had put into developing this fabric and creating this product.
Yeah, I thought this was all about wool socks and all the clothing was just a lost leader, you know? But it turned out that I was wrong.